Neoliberalism is an ideology built on top of three pillars: economics, politics, and culture. So neoliberalism is not just the term that describes today's form of capitalism. That's pretty close. But neoliberalism goes beyond that. So from an economic perspective, neoliberalism puts money above everything. Profit making is all that matters. Everything that we do should be to stimulate more growth. Because there are two ways to make more profits. You can either become more efficient or you can grow bigger. So growth is the easy one that's almost guaranteed. It's hard to always become more and more and more efficient. Eventually you're there, you're at a plateau. For whatever reason, we've convinced ourselves that we can grow infinitely without a plateau. We will dispel that myth in future videos. But that's neoliberalism from an economic standpoint. Money above all else, and therefore, survival of the fittest. If you can't make money, you're going to be out. And so that survival of the fittest mindset has led to a consequence of neoliberalism that we're seeing, which is entire markets are becoming consolidated into these singular mega corporations. And we'll take a closer look at some of those companies in other videos as well. So neoliberalism from a political perspective says that government's sole purpose is to promote capitalism, both at home and abroad. A neoliberal government exists only to help stimulate our economic growth. It is there to remove obstacles for businesses and markets to continue doing what they do and growing and growing and growing and making more money, because that's all that matters. So from the economic and from the political side, it's all about GDP as the metric for how fast we're growing, how well we're growing. GDP is the arbiter of everything. So that's economics, political. Culturally, neoliberalism takes that survival of the fittest mindset from businesses and applies it to us as individuals. And so we are in constant competition with our friends, our neighbors. We are constantly trying to make more money than them, to invest our money better, to have outward reflections of how much money we have, better cars, better houses. All of the things that we do are a micro version of businesses trying to grow and maximize profits as much as possible. Our entire livelihood is based on how much we produce from an economic standpoint, and how much we consume from an economic standpoint. Doesn't matter if you're healthy, active, coach of your kid's soccer team, whatever you're doing. If you're not contributing to GDP, you are unproductive in the neoliberal world. That mindset now pervades through economics, politics, and culture. We see it in that so many public spaces are being torn down because they're not profitable. Smaller, you know, family-run shops on the corner are being torn down and replaced with new office space. My hometown in Burlingame, in the Bay Area, that's happening a lot. Office space and housing seem to be the most profitable. At least before coronavirus, office space was up there too. Housing, real estate essentially is the most profitable use of land in the Bay Area. So anything that's not maximizing profits as effectively as possible needs to be replaced. That's why it's so hard to go anywhere without spending money these days. That's a cultural consequence of neoliberalism. Things that aren't profitable have been shuttered, closing their doors. The words are escaping me because it's such a mind-boggling ideology. It has nothing to do with the fact that this is probably two or three. But neoliberalism, we've allowed it to overtake economics, seep into politics, and completely wipe out any sense of collective culture that we had before. Now our culture is just a microcosm of the economic structure and business. All we can do as people is produce and consume. That's the meaning of life in a neoliberal world. So that's why I say neoliberalism is built on top of those three pillars. There is a whole set of economic ideas, absolutely. There is a whole set of political implications, no doubt about it. The thing that is most unique about neoliberalism is the way that it has warped our entire culture to reflect our economic system. And that is pretty curious. So we'll take a closer look at that. But if you need a little break, now's as good a time as ever because I need one. We've been talking about this for way too long. So go do something to make yourself happy because we got a lot of heavy stuff to cover in the days, weeks, months, and years ahead, my friends. But we'll make it happen. I love you.